I wanted to ask, Mike has such layers into it. We know his history, there's a lot of darkness into it, but there's a lot of comedy and comedic elements that are also brought into it naturally from Mike. So I wanted to know from you, Karen, as a creator, and then from Russell and Trevante, what was it like? How did you work out when to bring in those comedic elements into the story and how to just, or when, excuse me, to just keep it as the drama that it is and let it unfold it out? How did you balance the tone with those? Thank you.
The tone of the show was born out of Stephen's writing, which is very similar to the I, Tonya tone. And taking that approach and putting it into this series, one of the things we wanted to do was make sure that each episode was tight and almost felt like a boxing match, so that when you did stop to have those moments, you know, those conversations between Mike and Don, or a moment where Mike is reflecting, or in some of those more important moments, that they would be more impactful if you were like, go, 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 and then stop to breathe and really take that in. So that was part of the, I think, the music of the way we crafted the stories. And then that was aided by the way it was directed. And that was with Craig setting the tone for those first four episodes.
Thank you. And Trevante, what about you and your performance? Did you, I know it was in the script, but how did you balance out bringing that tone and then bringing it back to those elements and making sure that it didn't appear too over the top or sort of campy in that manner?
As a performer, I don't really look at it in that regard. I just, I guess it'll be a thing I say, but it's just, it really is just embodying a spirit for me. It really is. You try to educate yourself and arm yourself as best you can with as much information, as much aesthetic you can, and you just be present and you be the spirit. And that's what that was for me.
You know, I think for myself, when we talk about aspects of humor and comedy, I think everyone can, you know, kind of automatically look at Don King and look at him as a funny person, or, you know, somebody that we, you know, you didn't take seriously because of his word usage, his voice being, you know, of a higher octave or what have you. But I think what really you have to point out with Don is that I think that everything with him was intentional. And so I think he wanted to keep the world off balance. And everything, a lot of things with Don was done with a wink and a nod, because he didn't mind being the one that was made fun of, the butt of the joke, because he knew he was getting the money and that was his objective. I in my research, in my preparation for this, you know, in a lot of the videos and interviews, you never saw Don get mad. You never saw him take a tone that was in a darker, but only one time. And that was with Jack Newfield, when The Shame on Boxing of America came out and he was offended by his portrayal of him in that book. And that was the only time you ever saw Don have a curse word towards somebody or get mad. Other than that, he kept a smile on his face because he knew that being a Black man, that everybody was going to try to get under his skin. Everybody was going to try to invalidate him and his world, his actions and everything else. And people were just going to be coming for him. And at every turn, what everybody said about him, how they commented on his vernacular or his hair or whatever, he always kept a smile. And I think people, in that, he kept everyone off balance. Mm-hmm. And he didn't mind being the butt of the joke, or he didn't mind being made fun of, because at the end of the day, he was winning.